Hey guys, Hobbs here. What you're going to see today is part 2 of farming in Icecrown. If you haven't seen part 1, click on that square at the bottom right hand corner. It will take you to part 1. Part 1 we talked about just the graze and the coin that you picked up off of the mobs. We're going to look now more at the auction house, what it sold, and I'm going to be power leveling people as well. Just one person in this case, which is a 76 druid in this video. The repair was 26 gold. And the actual grays were, after you add them all up, it ended up being 118. We made 86 gold for the hour. As you see, he's trading me off a lot here. We actually got a lot more greens this run than you saw. And the other thing that when we get to the auction house, you'll notice that two, I think, Glyphs of Mastery books sold. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I was selling them for 750 gold per book. Now I got them about 250 gold per book, so that's going to be included in some of her auctions. So as you see, he's passing me everything, including the grays. I'm selling the grays, and as we add that all up, it ends up being 118 gold in grays. Plus, you'll see we get a lot more of the greater cosmic essences. So far, I'm up to 16. Some of the dust and a lot more cloth and potions compared to the last one. The other hour that we sold ended up being a difference of, I think it was 68 gold. I had 17 repair plus a lot of loot. So take a look at that. It ends up being around 175 gold per hour. When I get to the auction house, this is an alt. We started at 43 gold. Sorry about the clarity on it. The one thing is I actually dropped the resolution of the game. And watch the gold here, 195. It's going to jump from 250 to 500 there, because one of the Glyphs of Mastery actually sold. A lot of the Frostweave cloth, like I said, is selling probably between 7 gold for this one here. It's over a few days, so you'll see sometimes I get it for 6 gold, sometimes 7, sometimes 9. The Infinite Dust I sell single, simply because sometimes people only need 3, so I sell them, they end up being, what, 436 in this case per Infinite Dust. Now, it does all add up. I have sped up this video as well, simply because this takes about 6 minutes for me to loot all this stuff. There's another Glyph of Mastery, brings me up to about 1500. Way back in my original videos, I said the little bits add up. Now the little bits happen to be a little bit bigger now, but as you see, a lot of my successful auctions are only 3, 9 gold, 4 gold. But the total is presently at about 1800 there. Now, sorry about the quality on this. What I did was I dropped the game resolution to 800 so I could show you the bag and the auctions closer together, but it actually dropped the quality. But you can kind of get the idea of it. I did add a few videos, guys, on my blog. So make sure you swing by wowhobbs.blogspot.com, because I have some people who saw my part 1 of Icecrown, and they actually did their version, but with different classes. So if you're not a paladin, you might want to check that out. So here we are, finally at the very end. We're looking about 2138 gold, 39 gold. So I'm going to send it to Hobbs, send him an even 2100. I always leave a little bit on my banker, leave the banker about 40 gold. So that worked out to 2100 for 3 hours. As you see on my auctions, I only have a few Frostweave cloth. Scrolls aren't selling. Nobody buys scrolls. Now, you might ask, how did I get so much more power leveling than solo? And here's a little... Alnarg and I got very good. This isn't part of the 3-hour footage. This is actually after when we got really, really good. It's just a continuing chain pull. We're not stopping. We just keep going. We don't loot. We just keep... And he's getting experience. In this video, I believe he is 77. And we just keep grabbing more and more. He's healing me through. Keep an eye on his mana. The key is I got to make sure every once in a while he'll grab aggro. I got to get aggro back, obviously. Because he's not going to take the hits as easily as, obviously, a plate wearer. So we get that down. And... congrats to Alnard, he's 78 now. We spent a lot of time in here playing. We actually started at level 72 in this area. The great thing about it now is we just go and it's just a big loot fest. So as you see, it's a lot faster than in my last video solo. And which brings me back full circle to I've always encouraged you do make more loot if you do power level people versus going solo. And they get he made I think around 40 gold an hour in the coin split and just passed me everything afterwards. And now that he's presently 80, where we're doing heroics and some knacks and getting to where the game starts to really take off. It just keeps going. Like, that's a huge pull. We were laughing once we finally got it down to a start. It was pretty fun. And you'll see in a lot of greens and everything else. And so that was a 78 ding. Here we go, 79. So after all the auctions and grays and everything else, I ended up working this out to about 883.33 repeating, of course, gold per hour. Thanks again for watching. Oh, ding. Thanks again for watching, guys. The Hobbs way of pulling. For those who this is your first video, I've got different videos all the time. We're getting back into Alduar in the next few, and I'm going to show you guys a few other gold hints. Thank you for all the my viewers who have sent me gold tips from my YouTube mail. I'll try them out, and the good ones I'll put in future videos. Till next time, guys, on the Hobbs way of pulling.